Spain, we issue every twice a year a big study on the luxury goods trends. The main issue is issued in October, and we also update this study in May. So the current report was issued a few weeks ago, and was really about understanding how the market performed in 2013 and the current trading of 2014. For me, market, luxury goods market means apparel, leather goods, shoes, fragrances and cosmetics, jewelry and watches, so a large spectrum of personal luxury goods, both worldwide. Our study is the results of a deep monitoring of more than 250 worldwide brands, for which we reconcile the revenues at retail equivalent value, and we analyze the trends by geographical area and channel and product category. The main results of the report is that this market is growing, still growing, at a pace of 4 or 5% at constant exchange rate, but the fluctuations of the exchange rates are really impacting a lot the final results of the brand. Euro is very strong vis-a-vis all the main currencies. In particular, the Japanese yen has been devaluated of more than 20%. The renminbi also is weak vis-a-vis euro. This is not positive for European brands that are the main bulk of the players that sell luxury goods across the globe. So actually, even if the market at constant exchange rate is growing, the final results in the accounts of the companies are not so brilliant due to the strong fluctuations of the exchange rates. In particular, we have a strong, let's say, slowdown of mainland China, which has become in a few years the most important market. Actually, Chinese consumers account already for 30% of global consumption. They buy, of course, at home, but they buy more and more when they travel abroad. So they buy in Hong Kong, Macau, but they also go to Japan for the price differentials due to the devaluation of the yen. They go more and more to Canada for education reasons. They go to the States, more West Coast and East Coast, and of course to Europe. So the consumption of Chinese consumer in mainland China is slowing down because of very strict regulation, anti-corruption in mainland China. The government is controlling a lot the consumption of luxury goods and is also in the process of, in a way, communicating a sort of moralization about luxury consumption. So this is impacting a lot in the short term, the luxury consumption in mainland China, even if they buy, as said, a lot when they travel. Japan is a market that I've seen a recent revamp of luxury consumption, mainly due to the devaluation of the yen, after many years of stagnation of the market. Japan, as you probably know, has been one of the key markets for luxury goods consumption for years, with very high per capita consumption, but is experiencing a strong crisis of consumption since more than 5-6 years now. This year, the devaluation of yen for sure repatriated a lot of purchases that Japanese people were doing while traveling. But let's say the net result is not a real increase in consumption, but just the fact that they buy more at home vis-a-vis when they travel. In particular, Japan is facing a very interesting phenomenon. We recently did also another research, a big consumer survey across the globe. We found them a big segment of what we call disillusioned customers, so customers that were used to buy luxury goods a lot in the past, but now feel a little bit detached by this consumption. And in particular, the young generation doesn't really seem as was in the past, so willing to just take the trends that are being developed in Europe and consume in without changing in Japan. Actually, the Japanese teenagers are considered the most creative generation across the globe. They tend to develop their own trends, pop culture, art. And so they don't just buy luxury goods or fashion goods because they are European, so they want much more content. So I said that this is a very important phenomenon happening in Japan, because in my opinion, it's a sort of journey of consumers from being very enthusiastic vis-a-vis this consumption and becoming more and more disillusioned. This is a market that for many brands has been an Eldorado for many years, and probably they didn't realize that the consumers were changing so quickly, and they really didn't put enough attention in nurturing this market. In China, is happening a very similar thing. Consumers are changing quite rapidly from being, let's say, omnivore and buying everything, all the brands, all price points are now becoming more and more sophisticated. We call them opinionated, meaning that they cherry pick the brands they like, they buy also niche brands, they buy more on the absolute luxury. So for many brands, have been a real challenge. They had to change completely their assortment. For instance, the big logo brands have to really get rid of the logo collections in the stores in a few months. It's important to monitor how consumers change and how consumers behave vis-a-vis these products in order not only to react, but in a way also to anticipate some of these trends. This is, in our opinion, an area where luxury goods brands have to invest going forward, because consumers are really that can afford luxury goods across the globe are more than 300 million. We estimate it in 330 million. So it's a huge crowd of people that it's not just that you can deliver the same product to everyone or the same shopping experience or the same value proposition. So I think that the major outcome of our report is that every market deserves a specific attention. Now US is growing quite healthy, but again, there are new generations of consumers that really ask for more values. We really think that more and more in the future, consumers has to be put at the center of these brand strategies and really deliver a very customized value proposition for the different nationalities and for the different segments of consumers.